The Green and Gold are going home to City Stadium.
And you can cheer them on. Good evening. Thanks for joining us. Packer training camp just 3 weeks from now.
111,000 visitors will come to Green Bay for camp from across the nation and dozens of foreign countries. The Packer Country Visitor and Convention Bureau estimates that all of those visitors will pump $66 million into the area economy.
And this year, the Packers are trying something different for the Railbirds. After a 50-year absence, the Packers are returning to City Stadium.
The team will practice there July 31st, and the public is invited to the celebration. CBS 5's Bill Walsh has the story.
City Stadium, home of the Packers until 1956, home to legends.
We were here for 32 years. We won six world championships while we were here. And greats performed here. Tony Cannadeo and Don Hudson and Cecil Isbell and the founder of the franchise, Curly Lambeau.
Fans can now add one name to that list. Brett Favre will help lead the team through practice here July 31st.
The history and tradition, I think one of the things that it really makes Green Bay and the Packers a very special story.
This event, one of many that will celebrate Lambeau Field's 50th anniversary. The city and the Green Bay School District were happy to join the team.
It is grounded in the right principle, organizations working together to benefit the community and especially the children of this great community.
The event is free, first come, first served. Concession sales will go to the schools. Fans will be encouraged to donate money for another good cause.
We're going to pass the hat to help another great community entity, and that's the Children's Museum.
If this event is a success, the team won't rule out another return to these hallowed grounds.
I think it's going to be very unique this year, and I think the National Football League and the nation is going to really take a look at this.
In Green Bay, Bill Walsh, CBS 5 News.
And the Packers will hold a short ceremony at 6 p.m. on the 31st, with practice to follow at 6:30. The team is looking to add temporary seating to accommodate every interested fan. Officials say the practice does not interfere with any East High School event and won't damage the playing field.
The U.S. Senior Open wrapped up its first day of tournament play today. Organizers estimate this event will draw between 100 and 150,000 people. The Wisconsin Department of Tourism estimates this tournament will bring in up to $25 million to the economy. A lot of fans say this is a treat to be able to catch some of the best senior golf players in action.
We watch golf all the time on TV and we golf, so, you know, it's interesting. Just to see all of them.
It's just to watch the rhythm and the tempo of their swings. I think that their short game is just phenomenal.
And Ryan Popke will give us a look at today's highlights a bit later on in tonight's sportscast. The wild weather, though, cut things short over at Whistling Straits.
Yeah, because of the weather today, spectators will have access to tomorrow's action. Just bring today's ticket.
Now, our area was hit with pouring rain and thunder. We had some lightning. We had some hail around here even.
Look at this picture showing the hail that came down in Howard. It was sent to us just after 5 o'clock by Jennifer Nealand. And meteorologist Tom Mahoney joins us now with the latest from the Forecast Center. What's happening now, Tom?
Fortunately, the hail is all done and over with. In fact, most of the rain is. That's a good idea to put some kind of reference, because we all know what a dollar bill the size
right.
of it, so we can see the hail. Yeah, good idea to always do that when you send in a picture, you know, a ruler or something like that. Now, the largest hail report we had was in Door County at Egg Harbor. Brussels came in along with Crandon at 88 one-hundredths. Now, nobody's out there measuring that close. Estimated to be somewhere less than an inch, but more than three-quarter. Kewaunee and Luxembourg right around three-quarter of an inch hail. Norman, some trees blown down, and that being in Kewaunee County, with Ashwaubenon having a 60-mile-an-hour wind gust. Well, I am here to tell you that everything has settled down, and coming up later on in this broadcast, we're going to take a look at the radar and the forecast. It's going to include some hot, but not very hot weather.
All right. Thanks, Tom.
I happen to know Jennifer Nealand, and so
really
thank her for that picture.
For sure. Yes.
Okay. She did a good job. Well, an increase in home invasions and burglaries in Appleton have police sending out a warning.
Lock your doors. Of the 82 burglaries of homes and garages this year, just 22 involved forced entry. Burglars are stealing everything from bicycles, tools, and iPods to stereos, cell phones, and cash.
Pretty careful about keeping the garage door closed and the service door locked, but you know, you have kids and they're in and out and they're playing in the neighborhood, so you never know. And actually, I did have my purse taken out of my car about 2 years ago, so kind of learned my lesson then.
And if you have any information about the burglaries, Appleton police would like to hear from you.
Steering problems are to blame for a deadly medical helicopter crash. A federal report says pilots told air traffic controllers about steering problems minutes after takeoff. Radar data showed the plane took a little more than a minute to drop into Lake Michigan. Two pilots and four members of an organ transplant team were killed in the crash. They were trying to get a pair of lungs to a patient in Michigan. A tragic ending in the search for a missing Milwaukee banker. The body of 56-year-old Keith Gores was found last night in Lake Michigan. Foul play is not suspected. Last March, Gores suffered a head injury while walking his dog, and family members say he became easily confused. Although saddened by his death, his wife says she can now prepare for the burial and begin the grieving process. Well, the little girl in Minnesota who is being called a medical miracle hopes to educate people about the dangers lurking at the bottom of pools.
What a story this is. That's Abigail Taylor. She was severely injured on Tuesday when she sat over an open drain hole in a wading pool at the Minneapolis Golf Club. The drain's powerful suction tore out her small intestine. Abigail was able to pull herself off that drain. She took two steps and collapsed.
I should be on the news. And she said, "Why, honey?" And she said, "Because we need to tell people what happened to me so that none of this happened, so this doesn't happen to anybody else."
Boy, Abigail is conscious and able to speak, but she does face a series of surgeries and could be in the hospital for some time.
Another storm today may slow the cleanup efforts in Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas after weeks of deadly flooding. On the Texas-Oklahoma border, rains keep Lake Texcoma inching higher. The water is almost spilling over the Denson Dam. It's a sight people downstream are dreading. They're moving livestock and equipment to higher ground and preparing to evacuate.
Extreme heat gripping the West. An excessive heat warning is in effect for Las Vegas. Triple-digit temperatures, over 100 degrees expected from Death Valley to Phoenix. The heat wave is a challenge for people to keep cool.
Oh man, it's miserable, man. I mean, you know, you can't seem to cool off. You know, you're uncomfortable all the time.
And that heat wave is expected to last for a few more days.
Well, some holiday travelers heading north got a surprise when making a pit stop.
Yeah, gasoline was actually cheaper in some communities.
CBS 5's Terry Kovarik explains differing tax rates and a promise made some drivers happy.
If you top off your tank around Green Bay, you can expect to pay $3.04 for a gallon of regular unleaded gasoline. But drive north about 30 minutes to Ocado, and you'll find gasoline for a penny under $3 a gallon. That's a welcome sight for all travelers, including those who've rolled over many highway miles.
I think it's a little cheaper here. It is cheaper than Mount Pleasant. So.
By how much?
Probably 20 cents. When we left home, I believe it was 317.
In fact, Ocado dealers say their prices have held steady for the last 3 weeks. They followed the lead of this station. The owner promised customers he'd match the lowest price in either Peshtigo or Green Bay. But 30 miles north in Marinette, regular unleaded is 2 cents cheaper per gallon. Distributors change prices daily based on supply and demand. But customers are confused about such price variances.
I don't really know what the difference is between like what determines what city is, you know, different prices, but I don't know. It's kind of weird.
Gasoline tax rates also play a role in pump prices, and that's giving drivers who stop in Menominee, Michigan, more gallons for less money.
This will probably get me right back into Rochester, filling up here. So
gasoline dealers will continue to base prices by balancing supply, demand, competition, and customer satisfaction. Terry Kovarik, CBS 5 News.
But cheaper gas prices were not necessarily found along Lake Superior's shoreline. Regular unleaded sold there for $3.17 at Munising during the holiday weekend.
The world's largest music festival has made Milwaukee one of the nation's top summer destinations. Priceline.com has named Milwaukee as one of the top 50 4th of July destinations, which they attribute to Summerfest. To celebrate 40 years of success and to say thanks to the community, organizers say they're making Summerfest extra special this year.
We're opening up the doors on the last day, the final Sunday, from noon until 4, free of charge, to say thank you. Come on down and enjoy what we built together.
And they're also going to have free cake and ice cream on Sunday. And one lucky person is going to win a Harley Fat Boy autographed by a lot of this year's performers.
Wow. Well, folks in Appleton were treated to some music tonight. That is Boogie and the Yo-Yos, and they are performing tonight at Houdini Plaza. You can catch family-friendly concerts there every Thursday night from 5:30 until 8:30 until the end of August, and it's free.
Well, airports are cracking down on liquids and gels at airports.
You can only have small amounts in your carry-ons.
Now, the options seem to be limitless. To carry around with you.
How you can still bring your favorite cosmetics in a way that's fit to fly.
And the hit Broadway show is done, but now you can own a piece of the Lion King.
And this famous polar bear helps a zoo reach a milestone. You're watching CBS 5 News at 10.
It's the Get Cooking Food Show with celebrity chef Bobby Flay. Win two tickets to the show, passes to a special CBS 5 First News Cooks, Bobby Flay-inspired dishes by local chefs, and Flay's cookbook. Send a postcard to WFRV or log on to WFRV.com and click contest for your chance to win.
What are you being charged for internet service?
I don't know, maybe $24.
$23.90.
What are you being charged for internet service?
$10.95.
$10.95.
Millions are discovering the real value of PeoplePC Online. Go to PeoplePC.com now to try us free for 30 days. You get unlimited internet access for only $10.95 a month. PeoplePC Online has a smart dialer with more local access numbers than AOL for faster, more reliable connections. You even get security tools to help protect you from spam, pop-ups, and email viruses. And you can continue to use your favorite instant messenger. Compare us side by side with your current ISP. Go to PeoplePC.com now and start saving today. So the next time you're asked how much you pay, proudly declare
$10.95.
Go online or call 1-800-213-8957. PeoplePC Online, a better way to internet.
Boaters, Michigan's fishery needs your help. A virus known as VHS is spreading in Michigan's Great Lakes. It doesn't affect people, pets, or wildlife, but it's deadly to fish like walleye, muskie, and lake whitefish. Please use bait fish only in the same water body where you catch them. Do not move live fish between water bodies and dispose of your minnows in the trash or garden when done fishing. Empty your live wells and boat bilges before leaving the boat launch, and disinfect your boats and bilges. A half cup of bleach in 5 gallons of water will kill the virus. It's as easy as that. Help protect our natural resources. Prevent the spread of unwanted hitchhikers and diseases.
From WJMN-TV, this is CBS 3 News at 11 with Aaron Davison, Tom Zaleski, Tammy Elliott, weather with Chief Meteorologist Tom Mahoney, and sports with Larry McCarron. Now CBS 3 News at 11, working for you.
Are on the rise, and consumer complaints about airline service are also up.
The Department of Transportation says the nation's airlines experienced their worst delays in 13 years.
Well, since the crackdown on liquids and gels on airplanes, chances are you've had to troll drugstore aisles for those mini shampoos and lotions to bring on board.
Shelley Boatshaus shows us how high-end companies are now rolling out these mini versions of all these cosmetics that are fit to fly.
Allison Ernest is a jet-setting travel agent.
We sell student travel packages. We work on site at the different spring break destinations.
Like many of us, she's had her stash of beauty supplies trashed while going through airport security.
I've started buying smaller things like little toothpaste just to bring with me.
Smaller as in 3 ounces or less, the federal limit for carry-on liquids or gels. Until now, flyers like Allison have been restricted to the travel aisle at the drugstore when looking for these airplane-approved goodies, but not anymore.
Now the options seem to be limitless. High-end companies are offering travel size alternatives, so it's become much easier.
Easier to find everything from mini versions of hair and skincare products to tiny dental supplies.
Prestige brands like Origins, Estee Lauder, and Clinique are offering travel size products, but there's also specialty brands and salon brands like Frederic Fekkai.
You'll be able to fly through airport security by creating a mini beauty kit of your own. Travel expert Ed Perkins says it's as easy as stuffing your supplies into a plastic bag.
The requirement for the
bag that you carry on. It has to be transparent, it has to have a zipper lock, and it has to be no bigger than a 1 quart size.
You can only bring one baggie on board, so be sure to fill it with the necessities. Skincare products are a good way to start.
You get a variety of products, cleansers, moisturizers, exfoliators, even bar soaps.
Mini tooth brighteners and cleaners are an easy way to keep you smiling, and now you can even add a touch of fragrance before you touch down.
Companies are offering roll-on mini-sized versions, as well as fragrance solids that you can just dip your finger into and apply all over the body.
If you want to save space and money, you can even find one-time use lip gloss, toothpaste, deodorant, and more.
You do not have to carry half of a household with you when you're traveling.
Allison says she can't wait to bring her favorite brands to her favorite destinations.
They're also convenient too. I mean, not only when you're traveling, but just to carry around with you.
Shelley Botat, CBS 5 News.
Now, these mini products will cost some extra cash, typically $4 to $20 per item. And remember, you can always pack full-sized versions of your favorite products as long as it is in your checked luggage.
But the problem is you arrive at your destination looking like heck. So that's why you need those little things.
As long as you have that little finger toothbrush. Yeah. I never saw that before.
You'll be set. Oh, well, the Lion King came roaring into the valley.
And find out how you can take home a piece of the magic. That's later on.
And it is in the 60s in northeast Wisconsin, but out west, oh my golly, just shy of the century mark in Las Vegas, but Death Valley still at 106. Not quite that hot in our forecast, but we'll have it for you coming up.
And here's a look at tonight's winning lottery numbers. Pick 3, 600. Pick 4 is 6975. Good luck.
WJMN cares what you think and welcomes your comments. Call toll-free 866-760-9566. WJMN, working for you.
A little bit of a shower left in Door County, and that is it. So the rest of us are going to see clearing skies overnight. Temperatures anywhere from the upper 50s to the lower 60s and very light winds. Now for tomorrow, a mostly sunny day. Temperatures in the upper 70s to the lower part of the 80s and a light northwest breeze about 5 to 10. Look at this. The clouds are moving out of the way. Just a beautiful sunset again. And we are clearing off. This is with our little shoot camera looking to the valley. 63 in Green Bay, 66 in Appleton, 93% on the humidity, calm conditions, and a rising barometric pressure. Now, temperatures around the area. Talk to all of our weather observers. Everybody in the 60s got a late report from Spread Eagle, Wisconsin, and the temperature there is right now at 66 degrees. Temperatures around the rest of the state, mostly in the 60s, 70 though at Wausau, 70 Milwaukee, Madison 72, and La Crosse 74. Those are the warmest readings in the state. Now, where is that little shower? On the Door Peninsula, and it's actually now left the Door, and it's out over the Lake Michigan area. That is it. The rest of the area remains dry. So when we look at the satellite and radar combination, yeah, down in southeast Wisconsin, there might still be a little bit of a shower. And yeah, in the east, we did have those hail reports that I mentioned earlier. So we're right on the borderline of severe weather. Forecast map then from tonight at 10 o'clock through tomorrow. Look at Wisconsin. We stay dry. There might have been one shower down south right on into Saturday, also remaining dry as well. But it will be turning warmer this weekend, and we'll check that out in the forecast in just a moment. Now, from our ground view, there's that one or two sprinkles up in Door County. Elsewhere, we're looking at clear skies overnight and then clear skies for tomorrow as well. So getting to the forecast then, here it is. Maybe a shower, otherwise clearing overnight, upper 50s to low 60s. Then for tomorrow, a mostly sunny and warm day. High temperatures in the 80s, maybe very warm if we go over 85. But then look ahead to the weekend. Saturday, near 90. That qualifies as hot. Sunday, 93. That almost qualifies as very hot. But then when you compare it to Las Vegas today, being in the 100 teens, no, it's nowhere close to that. But that's why we define it for our area. When it's 90 in Wisconsin, we call that hot.
That's hot.
Sure.
When 90 in Las Vegas, that's a cool day.
It's a dry heat, though.
Yeah, you still get
them. You feel it.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks, Tom. Those lions you have been seeing around Appleton, they are now up for auction.
Starting today, you can bid on 6 of these painted lions on eBay. The lions were used to promote The Lion King at the Fox City's Performing Arts Center. The show has come to a close, so now you can buy one of the lions. The proceeds will go to the PAC. The auction ends on July 12th.
Well, those farm fields surrounding Whistling Straits golf course have now been transformed into a championship village.
We'll take you to the U.S. Senior Open. Plus, one of the Brewers' top players leaves today's game with an injury. Ryan Popke has all the details next in sports.
Right now, there you see the latest radar picture. Couple of showers left in Door County. But across the rest of the UP, they are done, they are over with. 63 in Escanaba, 64 in Marquette, 94% on the humidity, northwest wind at 5 and a rising barometric pressure. Around the UP at this hour, mostly in the 60s, however, up on the campus of Michigan Tech University, a chillier 59 degrees in the Houghton-Hancock area. Low temperatures were in the 50s to right around 60, Manistee, Escanaba, Menominee. High temperatures today did go up into the 70s and the 80s. So we can forget about the shower. It's now done and over with, except for Door County. Otherwise, a mixture of partly cloudy skies, low temperatures in the 50s. Tomorrow, mostly sunny and warmer, going up into the 70s and lower part of the 80s. From Storm Team 3, I'm meteorologist Tom Mahoney.
They are America's hidden population. Over a million American kids cook, clean, pay bills, and raise their brothers and sisters all by themselves.
We've just lost both of our parents. I kept the family together.
And you continue to go to school. How did you do that?
Childhood's interrupted overnight.
You were a drug addict.
5 years, I try to keep our family together.
A day in the life of a child in charge.
Were there times when you wondered why your mom even had you?
Next, Oprah.
Oprah, Friday at 5 on CBS 3.
My car is right around the corner. I'll drive.
The first day at the 28th U.S. Senior Open at Whistling Straits had a little bit of everything. Low scoring, great shots, and in the end, Mother Nature showing her force. Suspending play with over 75 golfers still on the course. They will finish up their rounds first thing tomorrow morning, early in their day. The weather was gorgeous, promoting scoring in the red. One of the top performers on the day, John Fiedler. This is his third shot on the par 4 14th. Chips it in. He is 3 under. One man with a nice following out there this afternoon, Tom Watson, on the second hole, rolls home this putt for eagle. Watson currently tied for 13th at 1 under. To the par 3 12th. It's a short one. Lauren Roberts taking advantage. His and some spin to nestle it about 3 feet away. Roberts currently 3 under par. Another golfer in at 3 under is Jim Woodward. On the par 5th, 16th hole from the fairway, makes it to the green and the ball settles 6 feet from the pin and he would make the eagle putt. Great shot there. Your leader on the day, Eduardo Romero, with 5 birdies and 1 eagle. That eagle coming on the 16th. The long putt, which hits the cup, goes in. He's got a 3-shot lead at 6 under par.
Well, I'm playing great today. You know, I miss a good putter, but I make a good one. But just started, you know. It's a long way to go. But my swing is good. My concentration is good. I come here to win this tournament.
Eddie is some kind of good player. He's a strong player. I just played with him Sunday last week, and he played superbly. And he's just a beautiful player. I mean, Mike, strong and just a wonderful strike of the ball and a beautiful player. I mean, I just think he's fantastic for our age. And he's going to be hard to beat.
Here's a look at your round one leaderboard. Romero with a 3-shot lead over 7 players, including Vicente Fernandez, John Fiedler, Ron Voswich. Gil Morgan is 3 under through 14, and Lauren Roberts is also 3 under after 13 holes of play. Here's a look at the Wisconsin contingent playing in the open. Mark Bomofsky is 3 over through 10 holes. Peter Krause is 5 over through 16, and Jim Rolofson of New Berlin finished the day 9 over par. With a 30-13 record at Miller Park, the Brewers own the best home record in the National League. Away from Milwaukee, not so good. The Crew is 18-24, fifth worst in the league. The Crew proving their issues on the road continue, losing 2 out of 3 to the Pirates heading into today. All-Star Ben Sheets trying to help right the wrongs, but this doesn't look good for multiple reasons. Ryan Domet with a deep shot to center field. Bill Hall goes up the wall but cannot make the catch. Domet with the homer. Hall lands awkwardly from the jump, leaving the game with a sprained right ankle. Hall did not travel to Washington. Instead, he is headed back to Milwaukee. Pirates up 2-0. Hall's replacement, Jeff Jenkins, does his best to help the team, smashing his 13th homer of the year. But Adam LaRoche counters with 2 home runs for the Pirates. Brewers lose 6-3 to Pittsburgh. The Cubs with a chance to make up more ground on the Brewers, wrapping up their series with the Nationals today, playing in front of Debbie. 6th inning, Chicago up 1-0 when Darryl Ward rips one to the wall in left center. Mike Fontenot scores all the way from first. Cubs close the gap in the Central to 4.5 games with the 4-2 win over Washington. The Timber Rattlers going for the 4-game sweep against Cedar Rapids. Game scoreless in the second. The Colonel's Julio Perez takes advantage of the wind blowing out. This one over the wall in center for a 2-run shot. Colonel's up 2-0. T-Rats couldn't muster much of anything against Colonel's starter Trevor Bell. He strikes out 10 in the first 5 innings. T-Rats would score a couple of runs in the fourth, but Cedar Rapids prevents the sweep with the victory today. So a little drier here in the studio.
Yeah. Where you were, yeah.
You were getting wet. I saw that.
But hey, it was a great day out there.
But your hair dried beautifully. So.
Oh, thank nice. You. Appreciate
thanks,
it.
All right. Thanks, Ryan. Final weather check after this. Stay with us.
CBS 3 News is sponsored by Marquette General Health System.
The Marquette General Neuroscience Center is about more than the way your brain and nerves function, more than treating back pain, Parkinson's, or stroke, more than research on brain tumors, even more than brain surgery. It's the team of focused experts under our roof who make the most of what happens under yours. You can expect more from the Marquette General Neuroscience Center because we're part of your regional medical center.
Menards has the quality roofing solutions you need. Laminate architectural shingles are attractive and affordable. 35-year Biltmore is on sale for $15.99. Plus, when you buy more than $349 of IKO shingles, receive a $50 rebate back by mail up to $150. Finish roofing jobs faster with Boss Stitch. This lightweight roofing nailer features a magnesium housing and one-step loading, just $229 after rebate. Plus, there's zero interest till 2009 when you put it on your Menards big card.
Save big money at Menards.
Where did I park my car? Oh, no.
If you have trouble remembering what you don't write down, now there's an easy way to remember everything. It's called My Lil Reminder, the digital voice recorder that records without tape.
Blue section, row 18.
Just press the button to record.
Milk, juice, butter, and eggs.
Then play back your reminder when it's time. And look, My Lil Reminder even has a built-in LED flashlight. Other digital voice recorders can cost up to $100, but you can get My Lil Reminder with built-in flashlight for only $9.99. Call now and we'll send you a second one absolutely free. You just pay shipping and handling. That's right, you get 2 My Lil Reminder digital voice recorders with built-in LED flashlights for only $9.99.
To order My Lil Reminder, call 1-800-787-5769. That's 1-800-787-5769. Call now.
The drama is always on CBS Daytime.
You rock.
The passion's always on.
It was wonderful.
Naughty.
Naughty. How naughty have you been?
The thrills are always on.
If it helps her to attack me, go ahead.
Thank you.
Ah! Whoa! The young and the restless.
Smoking hot.
As the world turns.
Seize the day.
The bold and the beautiful.
Opportunities all around us.
Guiding light.
Stay tuned.
The drama is always on CBS Daytime.
Amen.
Aaron Davison's clothing provided by Lady Savannah Women's Clothing Boutique.
What are we waking up to tomorrow?
Calm conditions, Aaron and Tom. Yes, tomorrow morning looks to be a lot better than what this morning. And then as we look ahead to the weekend, 80 to 85 Saturday, 82 to 87 Sunday. And there it is in Haven. Haven's about 4 miles south of Cleveland. Cleveland is in Manitowoc County, and about 4 to 5 miles north of Sheboygan. We were asking Ryan about it, then I found it on the map, and there is the course.
Looks like it's Ireland,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. Doesn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, Tom.
Thanks, Tom.
Well, a popular polar bear is still drawing a crowd in Germany.
Yeah, his name is Knut, and he welcomed his 1,000,000th visitor today to the Berlin Zoo, showing he hasn't lost any of his drawing power, even if he is all grown up. Knut grabbed national attention after he was abandoned at birth by his mother. The bear has been raised by zookeepers his entire life, and fans continue to flock to see him.
He's just so cute.
Thank you for watching.
Actress Jane Fonda is coming up on The Letterman Show.
Lisa and Paul, tomorrow morning at 5. We'll see you then.
Thank you for choosing CBS 5 News. Remember, CBS 5 is always on WFRV.com. The Late Show with David Letterman is next. Attention, if you've had a